Hello and welcome back to Fortress Canine. I am Joel, the owner and head trainer, and I wanted to talk to you today a little bit about what makes Fortress Canine different. So one of the primary things that makes Fortress Canine different from almost any other trainers that are out there is that we do not use what I refer to as sport dog training. So what sport dog training is, in a nutshell, is almost all dogs trained using sport dog training methodologies are trained to bite and to hold on. They're typically trained to bite with a what they call a deep mouth bite, which means they are biting with their molars. And they may target them for different places. Some are targeted for bicep, some are targeted for forearms. And the concept here is that most of the sports were developed as ways of testing law enforcement dogs prior to them going out on the street. And for a law enforcement dog, when a police officer sends that dog to bite somebody, it's almost always to catch a suspect who is running away, right? They're running away. The dog is much faster. The dog can run. They can catch the person. They may bite on the tricep or the forearm. Oftentimes the person falls down, and they don't want the dog retargeting and injuring that person when they fall down in a way that is excessive, right? They want them to simply apprehend, hold, create enough pain that the person doesn't want it anymore. They're like, get the dog off. They kind of like curl up, and then the police officer is usually very close behind. Within 10, 15 seconds, they close that distance. They get a hold of the person. They tell the dog to let go. They put handcuffs on, and they take the person to jail. We're not training dogs to do that. You as a citizen are never going to use your dog that way. What we are training our dogs to do is to defend you and your family against violent attacks. So these violent attacks might be an attempted kidnapping for a rape in a parking lot or around your vehicle. It may be a home invasion scenario. It may be a potential flash riot, right? Something like that, where you are out and about, you're minding your business, and then somebody targets you to try and harm you, okay? In these situations, these people are being very violent, and they are intending to harm you significantly. All right. So our dogs, when they engage, they're not engaging to apprehend. They are engaging to fight a pinnacle predator, the human being, and someone who's already demonstrated that they're willing to use violence and are very aggressive. So we want our dogs to be able to deal with that level of stress and threat and to be able to either keep that person occupied by continuing to fight with them while you maybe grab your children and run to safety, or you run to safety yourself if you don't have any children with you. Or you can engage with the dog, and there are certain scenarios where that may be appropriate as well. And so our dogs can work either way. They can work with you side by side in a fight, or they can defend you while you create distance and get to a safe place. And one of the reasons our dogs are trained to recall from a distance is because once you're in a safe place, let's say you run to a vehicle and you get in your vehicle, start it up, you back out, and you don't want to leave your dog behind. So you call your dog to you, they jump in the vehicle, you drive to safety, you call the police and deal with the situation after that. So our dogs are not trained to bite and hold. Our dogs use their canines, which is their natural weapons. They bite with their canines, so they often are not biting with a full mouth. They're biting and putting their canines into the muscle of the person, and then they are thrashing through that muscle and retargeting and doing it again, right? So it is violent, because that is the only thing that stops violent encounters. The use of a dog is less than lethal force. And so it's not considered lethal force legally. And if you only use your dog like we recommend, when you have the right to use lethal force, which in almost any scenario we would train our dogs to defend you in, you would have the right to use lethal force in the vast majority of the United States of America. And so our dogs are there to fight, to keep the assailant, to keep the person who's trying to harm you occupied in a fight so that you can then do what you need to do, whether that's run to safety or whether that's engage alongside your dog, all right? Our dogs do not bite and hold, and you will see a lot of videos where dogs come in, they bite, and the person has a stick, which is supposed to represent a weapon. They're hitting the dog with the stick, or they may have a gun that is firing blanks and they're shooting the gun and they want the dogs to hold on. We do not do that. If somebody draws a gun, our dogs should release and retarget so that the pain of the bite on the forearm causes them to drop their weapon. It's also injuring their ability to use their hands, which are their threat. They can choke you, they can grab you, they can use a weapon if they have the use of their hands. So as we injure that use of their hands, their ability to cause you harm goes down, and you have complete control at all times so that once the person doesn't want the fight anymore, get them off, get them off. Stop fighting my dog, stop fighting my dog. Out is the command we use for them to stop fighting. Call them back to you, let's go, let's go. They come back to you, get on the ground, however you want to deal with the situation after that. We have multiple different ways that we train you during your delivery. But that is the primary thing that sets us apart. Our dogs are stable, they are safe and secure around your family and your other pets, and yet they're extremely aggressive and violent when it comes to defending you against an attacker. I would love to hear from you and hear your questions. If you are interested and want to find out more information, please click the link below this video. We will set up a consultation. The video just above this is about the different training levels, and there is a link with that video that will take you to the comparison of the different training levels that we have, as well as the prices and some of the information on our payment plans. I look forward to hearing from you, and I hope that you have a wonderful and safe day.